Hello, welcome to this complete tutorial on the free DAW called Cakewalk by BandLab. This is Zachary Brown and I'll be your guide through all of the basics you need to know to start using it. Cakewalk by BandLab works on Windows only and it will be substituted by paid products such as Cakewalk Next and Sonar. Cakewalk by BandLab remains available, but it won't get other updates in the future. When you open Cakewalk, the Start screen shows up with your most recent projects. Go to New Project to start from scratch, selecting the proper CWT template you need. For the purpose of this guide, let's go for an empty project. The main interface is composed by a central timeline and several panels that you can open and close through the double arrow buttons. You can show any missing panel from the Views tab. At the top, you get options according to the selected workspace from the top right corner. In this video, we will stick with the basic workspace. Do not forget to check the Help module to get additional hints and information when hovering over any tool. You may select the main project settings by going to Edit, Preferences. On Devices, select your input and output sources to use, and switch to Driver settings to define bit depth and sampling rate. To import sample files, drag and drop these onto the timeline. These appear as blocks called clips, complete with name and audio waveform, and collected within rows called audio tracks or channels. You can also extend the track borders to get a detailed preview of your clips. Now, let's see how to record with your microphone. Create a new track by clicking on Add Track in the top left corner. Choose Audio for an audio track, and select the correct input source. At this point, click on the Record button to arm the track, and check if the microphone works through the decibel meter. To start recording, use the Record button at the top. Enabling or disabling the metronome. The timeline displays time in bars and beats. Click on it to place the marker as the starting point of the playback, whose placement is also shown in seconds at the top. You can also switch to bars and beats by right-clicking on it. Start and stop playback by pressing the spacebar key, restarting from the original point. Whereas use Ctrl and W to move the marker as you stop the playback. You can also play any region continuously by enabling the loop button on the right and defining the region with the yellow markers. With Cakewalk, you can also compose MIDI. MIDI clips are made of notes that produce sounds like percussions, pianos, and other instruments. To start composing, create a new track and switch to instrument. With MIDI only, you create a MIDI track to connect Cakewalk with external instruments or input keyboards. Whereas select a proper instrument to use a virtual synthesizer, also called synth or VST, for generating notes and sounds within Cakewalk software. In this guide, we will work with synths only. Once the instrument track is set, import any MIDI file you have, or drag ready ones from the media on the right, under MIDI Groove Clips, or PTN MIDI patterns. MIDI files appear as clips with their respective notes, sharing the same synth sound of the track they are in. You can edit the synth sound by clicking next to the track name. To change the synth, right-click on the same button and go to Replace Synth. If you're looking for more VSTs, you can download them online and install them by going to Edit, Preferences. Open VST settings from the left list and, on VST scan paths, specify the path you have with your VSTs. Double-click on the instrument track to open the piano roll and start composing. This shows all the existing clips with no borders. Click on the left piano to test sound, and click and drag to drop notes with the right tone and length. You may loop any region to compose faster. drag notes to move them in time. Right-click on a note to remove it. And zoom in or out with your mouse wheel while holding down the Alt key. You can also open the controller lane from the bottom left corner to set properties such as velocity for each note by clicking and dragging. Besides the piano roll, you can open the step sequencer from the Views tab, very useful when working with drum synths. Here, each row represents one note and a different percussion sound, from cymbals to snares or kicks. Set the pattern beats and steps in the top left corner, and play the sequence in a loop with the play button. This way, you can turn steps on or off as you need, creating independent clips on the timeline. On the left side, you can mute or solo any row, and also click on the left arrow to set velocity, duration, or swing for each single step. In the top left corner, use the plus or cross button to add rows or remove the selected one. At the top of the project, adjust the time signature and also the tempo, which sets the conversion rate from bars and beats to seconds, measured in beats per minute, or BPM. A higher tempo plays compositions faster. Now let's see how to edit audio and MIDI clips with the Smart Tool. Click and drag any clip from its top border to move it in time, or to another track. Use Snap to enable or disable snapping with proper resolution. Click and drag from the bottom corners to adjust the clip length. You can also right-click and go to Groove Clip Looping to turn clips into groove clips and loop them repeatedly. Cut, copy, or paste selected clips with Ctrl and X, C, and V. Click and drag over a clip to select only part of it for cutting and pasting. To remove a clip, select it and press the Delete key. You can undo any action with Ctrl and Z. You can add a fade transition by clicking and dragging from the top corners, changing the clip volume over time. Zoom in or out with your mouse wheel while holding down the Alt key. On the left side, you get all the properties for each track. If any is hidden, make sure to extend the track borders and remove any filter applied from the top. Use the M key to mute a track and the S key to solo a track, muting all the others. Adjust the input or I source for each track and set the output or O source, typically the master track, which collects the resulting output sound of your project. To remove an entire track, right-click on it and go to Delete Track. In the FX section, click on the plus button to browse for any effect you want to apply to the entire track. This gets listed in order from top to bottom. Click on an effect to open its interface and adjust it. And click and drag the effect to change its position, so the overall effect on the track. With the I/O button, toggle any effect on or off, or all effects at once at the top. Right-click on an effect to change or remove it. On the extreme left, you can open the Inspector panel to access further options for the selected track or the master track. In the Clip Properties section, use the Gain knob to adjust the volume level before any filter or effect is applied, and correct the panning between the left and the right stereo channel. Use the vertical bar to adjust the output volume after filters and effects, while checking levels with the decibel meter. Show Pro Channel for more advanced options, such as applying compression or filters with EQ. You can toggle each section on or off with the I/O button. You can also get a complete overview of all tracks by opening the console view from the Views tab. Once your project is ready, save it by going to File, Save As. Choose Cakewalk Bundle or CWB to save your projects with all its imported files. Or select Normal or CWP to save the project with files saved as links for a lighter project file. To export your project as an audio file, go to File, Export, and select Audio. Choose your desired file format, sample rate, and bit depth, as well as what to export. Select Entire Mix to export the entire project, or choose the tracks to be exported among the ones you have enabled by clicking on their number on the timeline. On Range, define the region to export. Choose Time Selection to export the current green region on the timeline or the entire project. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you want to learn more about other software for free and quickly, make sure to check out our YouTube channel and our website. This is Zachary Brown, and I'll see you next time.